Hola amigos, this is Viri, and in this video I'm going to show you three ways for you to exchange your dollars into pesos, the best ways so that you don't get ripped off. My first tip before sharing the three things to do is not to exchange at the airport. Please do not exchange your money at the airport. You're not going to get the best deal there, okay? I know it seems like it's the easiest way, you're already at the airport. Well, let me tell you the first way, okay? The first way is for you to bring your ATM bank card and take out money from a bank ATM, okay? Not just any ATM, it has to be specifically a bank. That's the easiest way that you can pull out money with the best exchange rate. And these bank ATMs, they'll charge you anywhere from $3 to $4. I don't even think they will charge you more than $4 as a fee to get that money out. And it's going to be the closest thing to whatever the exchange rate is at the moment. Right now we're at anywhere from 19 to 20 pesos per dollar, but depending when you're watching this video, you will have to do your research. Just quick Google, what's the exchange for your currency? If it's dollars, what's the exchange from dollars to pesos? And it should tell you. And like I said, a bank ATM machine is gonna give you the best rate and it's gonna be your easiest options. Actually, there's a lot of bank ATMs at the airport. Once you leave everything, get your luggage, pass through inspection, all that. And just before you leave the airport, before you exit the airport, you will see to your right side several ATMs that are bank owned. Okay, my second recommendation on how to exchange your money is to go to westernunion.com. You're gonna go to that website, create an account for yourself. So you're gonna enter your name, your email, the details there, to make an account for yourself, and you're gonna send yourself money, okay? Now, for Western Union, you have to be very specific, not make any mistakes on your name, because whenever you go pick up that money, they're gonna want an ID, your passport, whatever you're showing. It has to match exactly as the name you entered on the website, okay, on the Western Union. So that's my second way. Make an account. Then once you created the account, you're gonna go to the website again, and then you're gonna send money. Click on the send money. You're gonna enter your name, yourself. You're sending it to Mexico, and it's even gonna show you some places where you can pick it up. My best suggestion for you to pick up your Western Union that has the best rates is a Banco Azteca. Okay. I'm gonna leave that name underneath. Banco Azteca gives you the best rates. It's the easiest way for you to get that money out if you send yourself a Western Union. So you're gonna need your passport and the number that they gave you from Western Union to pick up that money. That's what you're gonna need. If you are sending money through Western Union, my recommendation is not to send anything more than 500, I would say 450 or less, send yourself. Okay, because some of these places act a little silly because they have a limit to how much money they can give a person per day. Okay, so you don't wanna send, you know, some crazy amount of like $1,000 or something, and then they're gonna be like, oh, sorry, we can only give you like 200 per day or something like that, right? Okay, and like I said, Banco Azteca is where you can pick up your Western Union. You can do a quick Google search. There's several locations all over Puerto Vallarta. Just put Banco Azteca in Puerto Vallarta and it should show you all the locations. There's one in main downtown. There's also several bank ATMs all throughout the whole city. There's even maybe some in your hotel, depending where you're staying. And yeah, there's a bunch of places where you can take out your money safely and at the best rate. My third and last suggestion of how you can exchange your money is by going to OFX.com. This is the best way if you're sending yourself a larger amount. However, there's a catch. You have to have a Mexican bank account. Okay, so if you have a Mexican bank account and you have an American bank account, then you can transfer from one to the other through OFX, and that's your best rate to get for your money if you're transferring large amounts of money. Okay, so this is probably not gonna apply to most people, but you know, it could apply to my returning tourists here in Puerto Vallarta, or even any other place in Mexico, or in expats that live here for a certain amount of months, or you know, full time. This is a great option for you if you haven't done this, or you don't know about this yet. Go check out OFX. That's what we use here, since we do live here full time in Mexico. Now, if you are concerned of not bringing any cash, because I told you to send yourself money in Western Union, I told you to bring your bank ATM, then bring a little bit of cash just for an emergency, $100 US or whatever you feel comfortable with. And in case of an emergency, in case something happens, you lose your ATM card or whatever, hopefully not, you'll have that money there to use, okay? Those are my three tips. I will leave all those websites that I mentioned down in the description. I hope you found value in this video. And if you did, please hit the thumbs up and subscribe for all things Vallarta. Thanks for watching.